I'm Yunzhu Li, and I just graduated from MIT CSAIL. At MIT, I worked with Professor Antonio Taroba and Professor Russ Tedrick. My research is on the intersection of computer vision, machine learning, and robotics. My research goal is to help the robots better perceive and interact with the surrounding environment, especially in complicated, unstructured environments like our house. And after graduation, I just joined Stanford University as a postdoc. We humans perceive the environment from multiple sensory modalities, like for example, vision, touch, sounds. If we want the robots to perceive and sense the environment, we actually have to add sensors to the robots. And since sensors could be, for example, RGB cameras, depth cameras, LiDAR sensors, audio sensors, or for example, tactile sensors. So my research, part of it is trying to help build this kind of sensors to expand the robot sensing capabilities specifically for tactile sensing. And on top of that, I have also developed algorithms and methods trying to interpret the data and allow the robots to know what does a specific sensing information means. This work is called DPINets, which stands for Dynamic Particle Interaction Networks. The goal of this project is to use particle as a representation to describe the diverse set of objects around us. So this project aims to build this kind of dynamics model that are similar to how humans imagine the evolutions of the environments using particle representations. And particle as a representation essentially represents the objects using a bunch of little dots in 3D space, which is a very general and flexible representations. And we use graph neural network to model the interaction between these particles and predict how the fluids will move, get back and forth if you shake a box of containers, and how plasticisms will deform if you use a robot gripper to grip it. And I have developed robotic systems, both in simulation and the real world, using particle dynamics to predict the evolution of the systems and the evolution of the environment, and using that predictive ability to plan the robot's behaviors. I think this thread of work can enable a lot of potential applications in the industries. For example, this work really unlocks the robot's capability in terms of how it can interact with deformable objects. And deformable objects are everywhere around us. For example, if you think about in our kitchens, we are constantly interacting with stoves or salads or peanut butter on a piece of bread. Being able to interact with these objects are actually very helpful for helping them to put the robots in the kitchen environments, helping us to do various tasks. And I think my research will be able to set up some initial momentum in that direction. And on top of that, you can also think of like the robots to do surgery. For example, the robots are also interacting with deformable tissues. And the third category will be to, for example, thinking about how the robots are interacting with humans. You can think of like building models for the humans where humans can also move around, but are also a deformable agent. So being able to better model the human also allows the robots to predict how the human will respond to the robot's actions and allow a better robot-human interaction system.